file of WAM server from Google. So I have here three versions of WAM. We shall stick to the second one. So you right click on this and say run as administrator. So all the privileges are given. Say yes. It is asking you whether this software should be installed. Say next. So you have to accept the agreement. Then only WAM server is going to be installed. Now, here you choose in which particular drive and folder you want to install the WAM server. I will choose it in C drive. If you do not want it in C drive, browse and select some other driver. Say next. Okay, so the previous version of WAMP is already existing on my system. So now I will delete it and then we shall install this. Okay, so the WAMP, I have uninstalled the WAMP server. Say next. So now I want a desktop icon, that is a shortcut, and also after the WAM server is installed, I want it to launch. Say next, say install. So now it is asking us which browser you want to keep as a default browser for the WAM server. By default, it takes Internet Explorer, but I do not want Internet Explorer. I will go for Chrome. So if you do not have Chrome and you have only Internet Explorer or you have Firefox, you can choose the browser of your choice. Now it is asking you for your SMTP and email. By default, it has these values. So just leave it as it is and say next. So our WAMP server is installed. Now here you can see the server has started and it is offline. It is still in green color. So here you have choice to put it online, to start all services, to stop and restart. So I will put it online. Now we can see the message server online. So let me just launch it. You have to click for localhost and phpMyAdmin is the database. So once you click localhost, this opens in the default browser that you have chosen. I had chosen Google Chrome. So in Google Chrome, I have got this. Now here, since we have not created any projects, it has nothing to display here. Now here you can see phpMyAdmin is the database. So this is how it looks. So if you want to create a new database, you go to this particular tab. You give the database name and say create. Now here you can see the database data one is created. Here also in the left corner, you are able to see the different databases. Click on data one, that is a database, and here you are allowed to create the tables. So let me create one table with the name students. It is asking me for how many columns. That is, I will say three and then say go. Now it is asking for the different table different column names in our table. So first one I will keep as ID. Let it be of type integer. Next, name, and then email. Type is the type of data, that is here I'll choose varchar. Here also I will choose varchar. Now we have to specify the length, maximum up to how many characters you want to or you are allowed to store here, and then say save. So now here you can see this is our table and here is the database. So now once this is over, you have to close the VAM server, put it offline and close before you shut down or log out of the system. So I will just say stop all services. So this is how to install the VAMP server.